What is up, guys? In today's video, we are going to be doing Meta Team versus Anime Defenders Infinite in this new update 6 and see on how far we will go into the infinite run. So the units we are going to be using are Dark Revenant, while we, oh my gosh, the Rift Sorcerer Awakened, ooh, Dragon Mage, Golden Adult, and last but not least, Lunar Empress. And we are going to be using this meta team in the latest Underwater City. So our highest wave is actually 115, so we're going to find out if the meta team can beat that. And remember, if you want to see more amazing challenges like these, hit that like button and subscribe. And let's get started with the video. Yippee-yay. Alright, so the first unit that we are going to be using is our Lunar Empress. So we do need to get our money up, so how are we going to do this? We should place our Golden Adult for early defense. Oh my gosh, I don't exactly know what is the best placement for our Lunar Empress, but I do think that we should upgrade our pink rockstar first so I know where to place my Lunar Empress. So I'll see you guys once I max upgrade my pink rockstar. Let's go. Alright, there we go. We have max upgraded our pink rockstar. So let's go ahead and place our Lunar Empress right here. So Lunar Empress is one of the best damage per second with her overpower passive and huge line AoE at later upgrades in this Anime Defenders Update 6. And Lunar Empress has an insane passive where she will gain 1% damage for every 20 kills she gets, which is insanely strong, and caps at 50%. And how to get Lunar Empress is through the secret Lunar Portal, which you can get Lunar Portals from raids. And let's go ahead and turn on our VFX. Let's go do that. Skill VFX enabled, damage indicator on. Let's go. So I'm assuming we will go beyond wave 115, so we can do this with the meta team. I hope so, at least, because this meta team right here, zoom in on this, are pretty meta. They're pretty meta, yes. All right, and if you guys do want me to like switch some units for the next meta team video, I would be listening to you guys' suggestions, since you guys told me that Rift Sorcerer is a lot better than Shadow Dragon. So that's why I have Rift Sorcerer instead of Shadow Dragon. Yeah, I'm listening to you guys' suggestions. And right now she has a 9% of passive. Ooh. Gain 0.05% additional damage for each enemy. I'll see you guys once we get her passive to 50%. Alright, so this was the huge line AoE out. This is not the huge line AoE that I was talking about. Hold on, guys. Yo. Well, so far she is 25%. So 25% more to go. But yeah, we're doing chill. We're doing good. All right, now we can get her to her huge line AoE. Moonswift Barrage. Now this is pretty huge. All right. I'll see you guys when we actually hit 50% passive. Alright, so the next unit that we are going to be using is our Dragon Mage. Look at that. So Dragon Mage is still the best unit in Anime Defenders Update 6. Especially, he is hybrid on placement and he buffs units' flame damage by 50%. And that is not all. He has the best stats with Almighty. Which is honestly insane, because the only way you can get him is through the Ancient Dragon Secret Portal, which isn't even that hard to get, and you just have to grind without spending money to get him like any other units, guys. Yeah. So yeah, we're just going to upgrade our Dragon Mage, and Lunar Empress got her 50% passive, so let's freaking go. Oh, this range actually goes down. That is so interesting. Well, So far so good, you know, wave 35, we ain't struggling on anything. Alright, let's max upgrade our Dragon Mage. And also, he does an AoE nuke, which is pretty cool. And that brings us to the next unit we are going to be using, who is Dark Revenant. So let's go ahead and place him right beside our Dragon Mage, because I assume they have the same range. But Dark Revenant is still one of the best damage per second unit with this overpowered nuke ability that will deal 3000% of his damage. Oh my gosh, and full AoE at later upgrades, especially the nuke ability he gets at later upgrades, is insanely strong. And how to get Dark Revenant is by summoning from the exclusive Wish banner, which you'll be needing to have Wish to summon. And how to get Wish is through the game mode Hall of Mirrors. And I recommend to have all of the meta units to do Hall of Mirrors. And having 2x and 3x is going to make the grind a lot faster, since before Hall of Mirrors was just not it. But having the 3x speed, it will just take like 5 minutes or even like 15 minutes actually. Yeah, 15 minutes to do Hall of Mirrors, which is a lot better than doing it for 30 minutes, not going to lie. And yeah, Dark Revenant have a pretty high range, I gotta say. Let's freaking go,
bruh.
Yeah, so far we're not even struggling at all. Our Lunar Empress is honestly carrying us here, so let's go. Yeah, set this to last. All right, I'll see you guys at wave 50 to see the boss's health. All right, we are at wave 50 now, and let's keep upgrading. Oh, that is the max upgrade of our Dark Revenant. Let's freaking go. All right, let's see where the boss is at. Yeah, the enemy's health is, not going to lie, not even that high. 16,000. Yo, my Lunar Empress can destroy those enemies. What the frick? All right, that's the boss. Oh my gosh, so the boss's health is 105,000. Oh, that's not even a lot. All right, the next unit that we are going to be using is our Golden Adult. So Golden Adult is one of the most insane secret units, with his passive inflicting burn and bleed at the same time, and he becomes a full AoE at later upgrades with overpower stats. So I highly recommend on grinding for Golden Adult. And how to get Golden Adult is by defeating the new secret Golden Knight portal that you can grind for using the Golden Knight portals you can get through the last infinite mode, which is this infinite mode. Yeah, pretty cool. All right, he is also a full AoE. Who would have guessed? Yo, who would have guessed? But anyway, finally, the last unit that we are going to be using is our Rift Sorcerer Awakened. So Rift Sorcerer is one of the best secrets with his insane stats at later upgrades. He will become a full AoE and slow the enemies. And unfortunately, you can no longer get Rift Sorcerer Awakened unless you trade for him. So good luck to everybody who is going to be trying to get Rift Sorcerer, since he ain't even that bad of a unit still, since his passive inflicts slows on enemies, reducing their speed by 35%. That is pretty meta, if you ask me. I assume that people will get mad at me for using Rift Sorcerer instead of Elf Saint. I do not have Elf Saint Requiem right now, since, yeah, I cannot, because I don't have a shiny Elf Saint. I'm waiting for Elf Saint to come in banner again, Elf Wizardess to come in banner, so then I'll try summon for the shiny one. But she has not been on the banner while I am on, which is a very unfortunate. And this Rift Sorcerer have a higher range than Dark Revenant is crazy. That is crazy. You'd think that Dark Revenant should have a higher range compared to all of the hybrid units because he's ground, but he's literally not. Wait, what the hell? Yo, who is in the balancing team? We need to have a talk, because clearly Dark Revenant only have 36.9 range, whereas Golden Adult, Rift Sorcerer and Dragon Mage have over 45. Like, what the frick? Okay, Golden Adult doesn't have over 45, but still, that is insane. Anyway, now that we have max upgraded every single of our unit, I will see you guys at wave 60, since now we are just going to see on how long we will last. EPA. Oh yeah, let's use auto use on our abilities. Let's go. Yer. survive 60 boss, only 200. Oh, that's 2 million. Well, that's low-key light work. What the freak? Oh, our dragon mage actually did damage that round. Let's go, a whopping 400,000 damage. Damn, our Luna Empress is low-key carrying us right now. All right, we are at wave 70. 45 more waves till we beat our last record. Let's freaking go. And how much health does the boss have this time? Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wait, what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh my gosh, 10 million HP is kind of crazy. You know what they should add? I've been asking this for every single time. I've been asking this every single time I do these challenges. They should add freaking HP, boss HP on the top middle of the screen, bro. I'm telling you, it will actually save everybody's time, bro. All right, we are at wave 80. Ooh, that's the boss, guys. That is the boss. All right, how much health does this boss have? So this one have a shield. Ooh, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 million and 6 million, so 16 million HP in total. Wait, this boss is low-key light work because our Dark Revenant does like 3,000% more damage against enemies in his range. Yo, our Dark Revenant is just meta full AoE. Oh yeah, I just realized all of the four units in here are literally full AoEs except Luna Empress. That is crazy. Anyway, I'll see you guys at wave 90. So far, so good. All right, look at those rewards. Oh my gosh, Golden Knight Portal Epic. We need those Golden Knight Portals Epic. Right, so this boss have 41 million HP. How did we go from 16 million to 41 million? That's a question that needs to be answered. What the frick? That is crazy. All right, let's set this to first now. Ooh, the divine from our Rift Sorcerer goes crazy. Imagine if we had 8 Elf Saint. I think Elf Saint would have helped us by so much. But the next time I do meta team versus Infinite, I should have a Requiem one, because Requiem on Elf Saint is actually the best trait on her, not Almighty, since she is a 3 placement. Alright, wave 100. Let's go. Let's see. Oh, wait, you can actually fall off the map here. Wait, what the frick? This is the first time I found out about this. Yo. Anyway, wave 100. How much does the boss have? Ooh, so he has 32 million HP and 16 million as shield, and he have like a freaking, he's so fast. What the frick? Oh, this is the boss I was laughing about because he has no walking animation. Yo, he actually does not. I thought it was just it was bug on that one specific run that we did, but no, it is literally, he is bugged in anywhere because he's actually just standing here with no walking animation. Like, what the frick? I don't think this is intended, guys. I don't think so. Well, we are going to beat him, I hope. What the frick is happening? All right, we are. Yippee-yay, let's go. All right, I'll see you guys at wave 110. Oh, we are actually getting so close to where we left off last challenge. All right, wave 110. This is where we died. This was the part where we struggled. This boss is pretty fast, isn't he? Yeah, this boss is pretty fast. That is why we lost last time. Oh my gosh. Alright, so we're going to set him to strongest now. Our Lunar Empress. Then we should be chilling, right? I don't think we'll be able to beat him, actually. Because last time we couldn't even beat him. The first. Ooh. Yeah, people were telling me that I should have one time speed on enemies that are fast or like on hard parts. I do not know if that is the that's true. Yo, maybe it is true, because doesn't the 3x speed work the same still with the abilities? I think it doesn't matter if you have it 1x speed or 3x speed, unless it's different. Looks like we're about to beat him, Loki. So let's go ahead and replace our units. Yo, we can actually beat him, no? Wait, no, we can't. Yo, how did people beat him? Alright, Dragon Mage. Who did I sell? Oh, Dark Revenant. Alright, now this is the part where we stall because, what's up, guys? I hope you guys are taking care of yourself. And what is going on? Will we actually beat him or not? What the freak? It looks like we can beat him, Loki. You know, maybe if we sell our Rift Sorcerer. Alright, Rift Sorcerer, carry us. There's no way we're going to reach wave 115 still, no? Yo, I think we might reach wave 15 still. Well, we were pretty close on beating the boss though. That is pretty cool. I wonder if having Elf Saint will make it any different for us. Oh, the Divine actually. Oh, never mind. Divine is not enough for us to beat this boss. Yo. I think Elf Saint would have done a lot. Yo, wave 115. Damn, we couldn't even beat like the second evolution team. I think if we had Elf Saint, it would have been a whole different story. But the fact that we did that like 20 minutes faster than the second evolution just shows a lot how this meta team is a lot stronger for sure. But anyway, that wraps it up for today's video on using the meta team. And if you guys did enjoy it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and I will be seeing you in my next one. Bye bye.